G'day everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can build your own personalized script using Excalibur's Zen Scripter tool. Let's get into it. Okay, so the first thing you'll need to do is download the Zen Scripter tool. Now to do that and to make sure you're going to get the most recent version, you're going to need to be in the Taylor Drift Discord. There'll be a link to the Discord in the description of this video. Now, if you're not already in the Taylor Drift Discord, the first channel you're going to be in is this welcome channel here. You'll need to go to the rules channel and accept the rules first to get access to all the other channels that are in this server. Once you've done that, what you'll need to do is scroll down until you find the Excalibur section, which you have a look here on the side, Excalibur's Zen Scripter. So you'll need to have a look in one of these two channels. You can see download GPC app. Now you can see here, this one is Zen Scripter 4.6 or version 4.6. Make sure to have a look in the support feedback channel as well. And the reason why is because there has been some updates recently. You can see here, Excalibur himself uploaded the Zen Scripter version 5.1. So make sure to have a look in both of these channels to make sure that you're getting the most recent version of the Zen Scripter. Once you've found the most recent version, so for me, that's going to be this one here, 5.1. You click on that one to download it. And there we go. So that's downloaded here. That's going to go into my downloads folder. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back here, go to my downloads folder here, and you'll see here Zen Scripter 5.1. So I'm going to put that onto my desktop and then you need to extract it. So I'm going to go extract here. And there we go. So you can get rid of that now. And all we need is this one. So your Zen doesn't need to be plugged in or anything at this time. All you need to do is open the Zen Scripter. And once that's open, this is the first thing you're going to see. Now, it might seem quite confusing at the start, but I promise you, this is extremely easy to go through and set it up. Okay, so let me explain. First thing you want to do is have a look along the top here and choose your console or choose the controller that you use. And that's going to make it a little bit easier for you choosing all of your controller buttons when you're going through the options here. I'm on Xbox personally, so I'm going to choose Xbox One. And everything is set at the moment here. So fire, ADS, sprint, prone for Call of Duty. Everything is set here as the default layout. So if you play on tactical flipped or you play on bumper jumper or whatever it is, you're going to need to click on here and make sure you've got these matched to whatever your controller layout is. Since mine's on default, I can leave that there. The next thing we'll take a look at is the title screen just here. Now this will be what shows on the Zen screen when you have your personalized script selected. If you want to, you can just go with my script, but it's up to you. You have a maximum of 11 characters. See, maximum 11 characters. If you don't want to put anything in there, what you can do, if you're going to use this script for Warzone, you can just click Warzone and it'll put a nice Call of Duty Warzone title on there for you. So it's up to you what you do there. Once you've got your controller layout and the title sorted for your script, you're going to move over to the next part here, which is the mods for COD games section. Now, this is the part where you're going to choose your two button combination to enter the menu and which buttons you're going to press to move around the menu and turn mods off and on. So the first one you can see here is enter the menu. This is the two buttons that you're going to press to enter into the menu of your script. To keep it simple, I'm going to make it like the Taylor Drift script. So for me on Xbox, that's left trigger and the menu button. So I'm going to change this one from Xbox One RS to Xbox One left trigger. Next part is the scroll in mod edit menu and the toggle on and off options. So for this one here, scroll in mod edit menu. So in the menu, I want to move with left and right. So I'm going to go left and I'm going to choose right for this one here. And I want to be able to turn the mods off and on by pressing up and down on the D-pad. Okay, so I'm going to go in here, have a look, look for up, and let's have a look. And we're going to go down on the D-pad there. Now to exit the script, I'm going to leave that as B, and to enter the edit menu, so this is the button that you'll press when you want to go into the menu of anti-recoil or into the menu of the aim assist mods, I'm going to leave that as A. Once you've selected all those, you can now choose out of these mods here which ones you want in your script. Okay, so I want rapid fire. I don't want hold breath. I don't snipe that much. Auto jump, I don't really want. Sticky aim, that's the one I want there. And that seems to be it from this. So you can choose whatever you like, but that's it for me. And once you've done that, you can now go to the next section, which is the auto slide cancel for COD. And once you get to here, to make sure you've got the slide cancel mod in your script, you need to click this little one here to make sure that changes to a tick. And you can also change the shortcut buttons here. So if you want to change those, you can. I'm going to leave one the same. This part here, the slide time, this allows you to change the time between when you slide and then when the slide cancel activates. So if you want it to be a really short slide before you cancel again, you can probably just leave that there. It's actually a pretty good one. But if you want that to be a bit of a longer slide before it brings you back up again, you can make that longer to maybe 450 or whatever you wanted to. It's completely up to you. After that, we're going to go to the basic mod section. In basic mods, you can see there's a few options. So there's strafe shot, bunny hop, fast melee. You can all see it there. You can choose whichever one you want. You just need to choose it. And you need to do that by clicking on the little X and change it to a tick. So I want fast melee. I want hair triggers. I want bunny hop. I don't really care about strafe shot because I kind of do it naturally anyway. And let's see. I can pretty much leave those. So we do that, we move to anti-recoil, and this is the part where you can choose your anti-recoil. If you want to go through and choose all the different profiles and stuff, you can choose different colors and everything, go for it. But I just want to have a basic rumble anti-recoil, so I'm going to choose that, and I'm going to choose the anti-recoil Modern Warfare Normal. That's it. Now you can change it in the menu as well, just like you change it normally with a Taylor Drift script. You can still change the anti-recoil settings there, but if you want to change those here, you can do that as well, but I'm going to leave it on 20 for now. The next section is the aim assist section. Again, same as before, you just choose which one you want and what you don't want. So I want to have polar aim assist. I want circular shape. Even though you can still change the shape in the Zen menu, you're just choosing what you want at the start at. So I'm going to choose circular. I'm going to leave the radius and the steps at 15 and 15. Polar aim assist, don't really care. Don't want that one. Don't want that one either. So move on. I'm not playing PUBG, but if you want to make a custom PUBG script, this section's here for you. The last one is app settings. So if you want to change the font on the script, it's up to you. It's all just small customizations. But once you've gone through all that, we're almost done. All we need to do now is convert this script into the code and put it onto the Zen. So let me show you how to do that. Okay, so once you're happy with all of your settings, you want to come back to the second option here along the top, which is the mods for COD game section. And what you want to do is you want to click on generate and copy this one right here. This message will now come up, and all you need to do is read it. It tells you exactly what you need to do. Script was copied to the clipboard memory. Open Zen Studio, press Control N, and then paste the script. Shortcut, Control V. Okay, so open Zen Studio, Control N, Control V. That's all you got to do. We go okay. We open Zen Studio. Once Zen Studio is open, we go Control N. We make sure we click in here and go Control V. There we go. That's all the code for the script we just selected. Now what we want to do is save this script and put it onto the Zen. So we go File and we go Save As. Now let's save this as, let's say, My Script. And we save that one there. And that's going to be saved probably to the downloads folder. So let's go back, go to downloads, and there it is there, my script. So all you need to do now is put it onto your Zen, just like you normally would put a script onto your Zen. Now, if you're not sure, I'll quickly show you. All we do is we go to the programmer section. We click on this button here, the file directory, and we need to find where you saved your custom script to. So for me, that was in the download section, which would be here. And I find my script, put it on there, save. And there we go, just like normal. All right, so just to quickly show you what it looks like on the Zen to show you that it works, we go over to where it is on the Zen here. There we go. There's our logo. Enter the menu with whatever buttons you've selected and go through the menu with whatever buttons you selected on the Zen Scripter tool. But as you can see, it's all here. So rapid fire, everything's there. If you want to turn it off and on, you can do that. On, off, on, off. If Sticky Am, I noticed, doesn't have any settings, so they'll just be set to default settings that won't be able to change, but it's there either way. You can still turn it off and on, no issues at all. Your slide cancel stuff, that's all there too. One thing I did notice is with the slide cancel, you cannot actually edit the slide cancel time in the menu here. You do have to do that on the Zen Scripter, but leaving it on that default slide value works out just fine. You can see the rumble anti-recoil there as well. You can change the values just like you would any other time. If we go back and look at polar, aim assist, that's all there too. Radius, steps, you can change those with whatever buttons you've selected. Bunny hop, that's there. Turn that on. Fast melee, turn on. You get the point. Everything's there that we selected from the Zen Scripter is now here on the script. And you're turning mods off and on and setting stuff up with whatever buttons you've chosen. And there we go. So that's all I wanted to show you. That's how quick and easy it is for you to build your own personal script. I know there's some people that would have, for example, a Taylor Drift script, but only use two or three of the mods that are in there. All the others go to waste. So if you want to have a script that's a lot more simple, a lot more personalized to you and the mods that you like to use, then you should definitely be giving this a try. Maybe you've just got yourself a new game, there isn't a script for it yet, but you want to try something basic, you can use this tool and make a script for that game. I know it does look confusing when you're looking at that stuff and you see all the boxes and there's so many options, but once you download it, open it, just read exactly what it says on the screen and everything is clear. It's a very easy tool to use, and a massive shout out to Excalibur for building this and constantly updating it to keep up to date with all the new mods and stuff that people like to use. One last thing before I go is just don't do what some other people have done and use this tool or something similar and then go out and, oh, I've got me custom script. It's $20 if you join my Patreon. Fuck off. All right. That's not what this is for. Just use it to make your own nice personalized script and have a good time. All right. Now, if you do have any questions, ask them in the comments. Cheers for watching. I'll see you next time.